Today I am going to discuss about properties of fluids. Density is defined as the mass per unit volume. This is denoted by Greek symbol rho. So density rho is equal to mass per unit volume. The SI unit of density is kg per meter cube. And dimensions for densities is m l minus 3. This is the dimension. Generally, the density of fluid depends upon the temperature and pressure, but for incompressible fluids, we assume that the variation of density is with respect to pressure is very negligible. Another important property is specific volume. Specific volume is the inverse of density, and its SI unit is meter cube per kg. It is defined as the volume per unit mass of a fluid is a specific volume. Another important property of fluid which we will be using frequently in our calculations in hydraulics, that is a specific weight. A specific weight is defined as the weight per unit volume of a fluid. This is denoted by gamma. So gamma is equal to weight of fluid per unit volume of fluid. So the SI unit for specific weight is Newton per meter cube. Okay, so weight is in Newton and volume is in meter cube. So it is Newton per meter cube. Now weight is equal to mg and divide by volume. Mass upon volume gives you density, so gamma is equal to rho g. So specific weight is rho times g, where g is the acceleration due to gravity. Now specific weight of water is assumed to be at 20 degrees Celsius and at 1 atm pressure, it is 998 kg per meter cube. Okay, now this is the density. So specific weight will come out to be equal to 9810 Newton per meter cube. Okay, for our sake of simplicity, we take gamma equal to 10 kilonewton per meter cube. This is for the calculation purpose, or 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. This is for calculation purpose. Okay. Another important property is relative density or specific gravity. It is defined as the density of a fluid. You can say density of a fluid divided by the density of reference fluid, and for reference we generally we take as water. So density of a fluid divided by density of the water will give you the specific gravity of that fluid, and this is denoted by symbol g. Similarly for gases, so if we want to calculate the relative density for gases, so for any gas, the density of that gas divided by the density of air. In case of gases, we take the difference as air. Okay. Another important property is pressure. Pressure is the compressive stress on the fluid. It means normal force, pressure is equal to normal force divided by the area. Suppose this is any cube, any volume. This is suppose the force, normal force acting over this area, that is A, then the pressure will be equal to force over area, or force per unit area. The unit for pressure is Newton per meter square. This is the SI unit, or generally we take it as equal to 1 Pascal. So 1 Newton per meter square is equal to 1 Pascal. This is the SI unit. Okay. If suppose the pressure distribution is not uniform. Okay. Suppose this is a non-uniform irregular shape, so the area will be taken as dA and change in force is taken as dF. So the pressure dP is equal to dF over dA. This is for non-uniform pressure distribution. If the pressure distribution is uniform, then the formula is very simple. Pressure is equal to force over area. Generally, in meteorological calculations, we use the unit for pressure as bar. So 1 bar is equal to 10 raised to the power of 5 Pascal, and 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. So 1 bar will be equal to 100 kilonewton per meter square, okay, or 10 to the power 5 Newton per meter. 1 bar pressure is approximately equal to atmospheric pressure at sea level. Okay, so 1 bar is 1 atm generally. 1 bar is atmospheric pressure at sea level. So, which is equal to 101325 kilonewton per meter square. Okay. Now, pressure is generally denoted in terms of height of an equivalent column of a fluid. So, when suppose this is a column of a fluid, suppose this is a control volume, this is filled with water, and in this control volume, we take this column, this water column of height h. Okay. So in that case, the pressure will be equal to rho times g times h. Okay. Rho times g times h. So the pressure will be equal to rho times g is gamma, so will be equal to gamma h. Okay. This will be the pressure in terms of head or height of an equivalent column of a fluid. This is a relation for pressure, where rho is the density of that fluid, g is the acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height. Suppose this is a channel section, and the depth is say h, then here the pressure at this bottom will be equal to gamma of this fluid. Suppose this is water, so gamma of water, specific weight of water, times h. Okay. Another important property is viscosity. Viscosity is the inherent property of a fluid, okay, which offers resistance to flow. So viscosity is actually a quantitative measure of a fluid's resistance to flow. Suppose in air, if we want to move in air, then we can easily move. There is very little resistance offered by the air to this motion. Okay. Now suppose in water, which is having 50 times more viscosity than the air. So what will happen in water? The water will apply much resistance to the flow as compared to the air. It means the viscosity is playing a role in resisting the motion. suppose another fluid which is SAE30 oil. SAE30 oil is a oil which is used in motor engines. So suppose this oil is having 300 times more viscosity than the water. So then in this fluid, the resistance offered will be more than the water, much more than the water. Similarly for glycerin, glycerin is very viscous than the water, so again the viscosity is very high, so it will it cannot be moved that much easily. Okay, so viscosity plays a very important role in whenever there is the layers try to move. Okay, now suppose this is a fluid particle. Okay, this block is having a dimension delta x in this direction and delta y in this direction. This is 2D. If it is 3D, then delta z in this direction. Since this is 2D, so we will take only delta x and delta y. This figure shows the variation of velocity along the depth. Okay, this is the depth of water. Suppose this is the free surface. Okay, and this is the rigid boundary. Okay, this is the rigid boundary. Since this boundary is not moving, so velocity of this boundary is zero. And the water molecules or fluid molecules in contact with this boundary, the velocity of those molecules will be equal to zero. This condition is known as no slip condition. Okay. And at the free surface, the velocity is u, and the variation of the velocity is not uniform, is not linear. Okay, it's not linear since this is a real fluid, so it is not linear, but it is parabolic like this. Okay, this is parabolic. The velocity here is zero because of the no slip condition, and the here it is u, and the variation along this depth is not linear but parabolic. Okay, so suppose we offer a shear deformation of angular deformation of delta theta. Okay, we applied some shear stress tau here, and due to this shear stress the angular deformation is delta theta. Let us assume that. Now the change in velocity from here to here is say delta u, because this is very small velocity. Say the change is delta u. Okay, and time taken will be delta t. So this distance will be delta u times delta t. Okay, now take tan delta theta equal to delta u delta t over delta y. Okay, perpendicular over this. So delta u delta t over delta y. Now since this deformation is very small, so this delta theta is very very small, so we can take tan delta theta equal to delta theta, and when we rearrange this, so it will become delta theta by delta t is equal to delta u over delta y. Okay, Now, this term represents the change in angular change or angular deformation with respect to time is equal to velocity gradient. Okay? Means change in velocity with respect to the depth. So this is change in velocity with respect to the depth, that is velocity gradient. Velocity gradient along y direction. Okay, and this is the angular deformation with respect to time. Okay, so this is say equation one. Keep this equation in mind. Okay. Now, by observation, we have observed that the shear deformation is proportional to the angular deformation with respect to time. That is delta theta by delta t. Shear deformation, shear stress is proportional to delta theta over delta t. Now, since delta theta by delta t is equal to delta u over delta y, and when we remove proportionality then we have to put some constant here, so this is say mu, so it will become mu delta u over delta y. And so this will become mu times du over dy. Okay, this is very important expression, where tau is the shear stress, du over dy is the velocity gradient along y direction, and mu is the coefficient of viscosity. Coefficient of viscosity. And this expression is known as the Newton's law of viscosity. Okay. Newton's law of viscosity. Okay. So according to this, shear stress is proportional to the velocity gradient. Okay. Where mu is the coefficient of viscosity or dynamic viscosity. Dynamic viscosity or simply viscosity. The unit, SI unit for viscosity is, now try to find out the viscosity unit for viscosity. So mu will be tau over du over dy. Okay. Tau is shear stress, so unit for shear stress is Newton per meter square, okay, SI unit, and unit for du is meter per second, and unit of dy is meter. Okay, so now rearranging this, we will get unit for mu is equal to Newton seconds per meter square. Okay, Newton second per meter square will be the unit, SI unit, remember this one, SI unit. Okay, sometimes we use another unit for viscosity, dynamic viscosity, that is poise. So one poise is 0.1 Newton second. Now, viscosity depends upon the temperature and pressure. Okay. So, suppose this is molecules of air. Okay, these are the molecules of air. And we try to raise the temperature. Okay, we try to raise the temperature. Then what will happen? Due to the increase in temperature, these molecules will vibrate and will try to expand. Okay, this will try to expand. But what will happen? Due to this, the collision of particle will take place. Okay, the collision of particle will take place. Due to this collision, the viscosity will increase. Okay, the viscosity will increase. Now it's your homework to find out what will happen when the temperature increases in case of liquids. Okay, I will discuss this one later on. Another viscosity is kinematic viscosity. Okay, kinematic viscosity. It is the ratio of the dynamic viscosity to the density of fluid. This is denoted by the symbol nu. The unit for kinematic viscosity is meter square per second. Okay. It is also denoted by stroke. So one stroke is 10 raised to the power minus 4 meter square per second. Okay, meter square per second is the SI unit. Now I have discussed in this slide the Newton's law of viscosity. All those fluids which follow Newton's law of viscosity are known as Newtonian fluids. Newtonian fluids. Most of the real fluids, air, water, like this, these are all the Newtonian fluids. Okay. But those fluids which do not follow Newton's law of viscosity, that is, which do not follow this equation, tau is proportional to du over dy, it does not satisfy this condition. Okay, which does not satisfy this condition, these are all the non-Newtonian fluids. In this case, tau is equal to mu du over dy raised to the power n, where m is the consistency index and n is the flow index. Okay, some of the examples of non-Newtonian fluids are blood, suspension of cornstarch in water, polymer solution, paints, paste, slurries, all these are the example of non-Newtonian fluids. Okay. I have discussed some important terms, density, what is density, what is relative density, okay, and what is viscosity, what is Newton's law of viscosity and kinematic viscosity. All these important properties I have discussed, and units and dimensions of these properties of fluid. Okay. If you have any question regarding this, you can contact me, and you have to download the study material, okay, from this website. Okay, you have to download the study material, and then you have to ask the questions. Whatever the problem you have to ask the question to me. Okay, so this is the end of this lecture. I hope you have learned a lot. Okay, thank you.